Okay, we're looking at a short leg scoliosis. This is a recent patient of mine. She's only 20. She's given me permission to use her x-rays for some education here. Now, let's look at this left-sided x-ray. I'm just going to magnify it a little bit. This is the patient facing us. So zoom it right in here. And if she's facing us, then we've got her left hip here and her right hip here. And I want to show you how a short leg causes a scoliosis or curvature of the spine. I think you can get a sense that her spine's way off to the side here. And over here on the right, you can actually see the state of her spine. She's got a double scoliosis here. Again, this is her left side over here. She's facing us. Again, her left side here. Now, if I zoom right in, I want to show you that I've marked the top of her hips. And if I change the contrast, so you can see that a little better. Here's the outline of her left hip here. Okay? And you can see I've drawn a line on the top of that hip. And if I move across, you can see the right hip, the outline there. And again, I've drawn a line straight across and brought it all the way across to the side, and you can see there's a big difference. This is a weight-bearing x-ray. She's standing up. If I take a little measurement to see how much of a short leg she has 9.2 millimeters. That's what the measurement shows us there. Almost a centimeter. That's quite a big, big jump there. So let's just go back to the regular. Scroll back out again here. And I'll just move that x-ray over. So there you see she has a definite short left leg. So her, and here you can also see, if I draw on a line there, the sacrum, that's this bone here, is definitely tipping down to the left there. Let's just move that number out of the way. And it's pulling her spine in that direction. Over here, let's take a look now at the scoliosis up close, and there you can see there's the tops of the pelvis and this bone in here is the L5 vertebra. That's this one, the last vertebra of the lumbar spine, and you can see she's got a substantial scoliosis. These lines are drawn in S1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and the measurements between S1 and 5 will give her scoliosis. S1, S5 equals 42.4 degrees. That's a very large scoliosis. Let's just center that again and take a look as I zoom back out here. Give you a real sense of what you're looking at. Okay. There we go. So you can really see there's that 42 degree scoliosis, and the body's done a good job here. It's trying to straighten itself out, so it's actually given her another curvature in order to finally straighten her right around where her heart is. So she gets a lot of symptoms. She's been sore through her back much of her childhood, all the way down here. No one's ever taken an x-ray. This is the first time she's had one taken, and now we're working together to get her a lot more comfortable. And there you see a short leg scoliosis, a curvature of the spine caused by a short leg. With this particular patient, I'll be giving her a small heel lift to give her an artificial lengthening of this leg, and then we'll do some work through the joints of the spine, get her a lot more comfortable and a lot healthier. I hope you enjoyed that and learned something about scoliosis and one of the causes. Thanks for watching. Join me at posturevideos.com and post any questions that you have about scoliosis or short leg. Thanks very much.